Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Armin and this is second part of how to prepare a propeller for CFD analysis. In this episode, I will teach you how to generate a mesh with periodic boundary condition in ANSYS Fluent. I'm going to double click on the mesh to start. Then I'm going to specify the number of processors and check double precision. Okay, this is WaterTight geometry module. I want to import geometry in this module, so I'm gonna click on import. I prepared this geometry in the first part, and now I want to create a proper mesh for geometry. First, it's better to create a coarse mesh, so we leave the local size. In generate surface mesh, we can see the default maximum and minimum element size. I won't change the default size and click on generate.
A warning appeared because the mesh quality was low. It is suggested to use surface mesh improvement. The mesh size is too large because the surface of propeller needs a fine mesh. We have to reduce the mesh size until we reach the proper quality. The mesh size is still large, so I'm going to make it smaller. As you can see, the asterisk mark has disappeared, indicating the surface mesh size is proper. We can't see mesh, obviously, so I'm going to change the light scene. Okay, I think we can see mesh better now. It's time to set up periodic boundaries, so I'm going to right-click on Generate the Surface Mesh and select Periodic Boundaries. I'm going to select two sides and click on Setup. We can see here the circular pattern angle, origin, and vector. A warning pops up saying that the mesh has been regenerated, because mesh was asymmetric. Now, I want to describe geometry, define options according to these notes. Boundary layers increase the accuracy of results. Three boundary layers will be added by default and I won't change it. Now, I'm going to specify the volume mesh according to ANSYS recommendations. The minimum orthogonal quality is above 0.15, which is adequate. And it is the total number of cells. Now, I'm going to refine the mesh. In this step, I'm going to add local sizing mesh. As you see, the cells of the rotary domain are coarse. So I'm going to add a body size and specify 3 millimeters. The rest of the steps are the same as before. I want to define a boundary layer for Y+. Therefore, according to these steps, I specify the boundary layer with a height of 0.01 mm. Finally, I'm going to click on Generate Volume Mesh. The number of cells and mesh quality have been increased. You see here three layers. Mesh generation completed. So I'm going to click on the switch to solution. The second part of this episode has been finished. Thank you for watching.